What up, guys? Here again with the dragon. Brings you a build with Nightcrawler, one of my favorite characters. I've been waiting for this guy to come out. He's popping all over the place. He's bamfing. There's purple smoke everywhere. He's beating people up left and right. He's giving people the Floyd Mayweather left, right, coming through with the Conor McGregor KO. It's a lot of fun to play. He's a whole lot of fun to play. And sorry for the lack of updates also. I had a big hiatus. I got married out in Bermuda, picture right, boom, right there. And also had another really, really big change in my real life, and had a nice little move. So it was it's been a lot of fun, but nonetheless, we'll pop over to the build here. First off, I'll start off with his traits. He's got on guard, which gives him dodge chance, deflect chance, and obviously the melee combat reduction. And then you have the incredible Nightcrawler. This kid is a beast with the criticals as well as the brutal hits, plus 3%. His spirit, which it doesn't say on here for whatever reason, it does regenerate over time. There's a slight pause whenever you are attacking with an attack. It'll stop his spirit, and I think it regenerates 2 or 3 seconds afterwards. Next up, we have his powers. So you can see I have quite a few of his teleport powers, but then I have all his flourishes, and that's because of the specific build that I have here. Very high critical chance, does a ton of damage, or teleporting all over the place. The first one I have, key to my X, is run through. This is going to be his teleport. It has 100% critical chance with the particular stealth build that I have. It's 100% critical damage, pretty basic power. It does so much damage. I love to use this attack, probably one of my most damaging, like, single quick hitting attacks. Next up, we have key to my square button, death blow. Deliver decisive blow, laying low any enemy, especially if they're close to death. You know, does roughly 8k damage on average. Again, you'll have 100% critical hit chance with this. With this particular build, and it's an execute as well, so you see that damage really start to boost up as people are low on health. And both of these attacks pop up every 6 seconds, so you're going to be using these on cooldown non-stop all over the place. Then we have key to my triangle button, saber storm. Has a small bit of crowd control because it immobilizes people, does 6 hits, does a ton of damage, definitely capable of rivaling run through. Has, you know, a small spirit cost associated with all three of these abilities. I really haven't had any spirit issues using the Gaborim relic. This one has 8 second cooldown, a little bit longer, but it'll be popping up non-stop. And on my O button, as always, gotta have a teleport, especially with this guy. He comes with 5 charges of teleport, which put him into stealth, which is going to be key. After every single attack, you're going to want to teleport. That'll put him into stealth. That'll bring up that 100% critical stealth buff and really just let the damage fly. Then on my L2X button, I have keyed BAMF bomb. Very nice ability, a movement teleport. That's key to my L2O button. He'll have, you know, this does quite a bit of damage. You get a plus 200% damage bonus when used while stealth again, and it also restores the stealth charge. 4 second cooldown. You'll have more higher priority cooldowns, but this is going to be one of your main bigger hitting AoEs. This will actually hit everybody rather than teleport to each individual and hit them, such as Brimstone Blitz or Blink Strike. And I'll go ahead and go to Blink Strike next. Get to my L2 square. Unleash a rapid teleport between nearby enemies, striking them as you pass. Hits up to 6 nearby enemies. Also restored the charge of BAMF, which is very, very nice. This will, you know, pop around to a few people. I really like to use this just to add a little bit of DPS, and more importantly, restore that charge of BAMF, because I'm always teleporting. In my opinion, if it hit everyone around you at the same time, it'd be a little bit better. The damage for me is pretty negligible because your other attacks do so much. But again, it is in my rotation. I like to use it, especially when I think there's a slight invulnerability as well while you're teleporting around. So I really like to use this if something's about to hit pretty hard. Then on my L2X, very fun ability, Righteous Frenzy. This does really nice damage, but more importantly, it has 3 charges, so it's not going to do as much damage as, say, one of your flourishes due to the stealth factoring in, giving you a critical chance. of 100%, but with the three charges and the fact that talented, it'll restore your signature along with BAMF bomb. With these two skills, you'll be using these pretty much on rotation, really just popping this three times in a row and getting the AoE damage and letting, you know, getting with a higher critical and brutal chance, it'll be doing a lot more damage, so that's nice. And last up, L2 triangle, we have Brimstone Blitz. This is your signature here. For me, this does a lot of damage, and I have a spec for the cooldown, so whenever I use the Righteous Frenzy or BAMF bomb, they are going to be both lowering the cooldown of this attack. Again, does really nice damage. I've seen this brutal for, you know, 150 to 200k with 10 hits on a single enemy. This will do an insane amount of damage, especially if it's critting and brutaling. On a multitude of enemies, the damage to me is pretty negligible, just due to the fact that it hits one enemy per hit. And then the invulnerability is there as well for 5 seconds. So if you're about to get ran over by a Rhino or Juggernaut, pop this, you'll be invulnerable for 5 seconds. Just be aware that once you come out of invulnerability, you'll be like in the exact same spot unless you move some during it. Then we've got the talents. So I'll just quick run through. I've got surprise attack, which gives you 100% damage if you used while in stealth or invisible for BAMF bomb and run through. This would be nice. Again, we're teleporting after every single attack, so you're always going to have this 100% up. Then I've got Oswechen. I have no idea how to pronounce that. When you use a teleport, you gain plus 2% base damage, plus 2% dodge chance for 4 seconds. You'll pop around non-stop, and you already have a lot of the teleport powers in your rotation. This is pretty active, probably one of the more active builds that I've definitely played. So you're going to be moving around non-stop. The 4 second duration should be a problem as it stacks. And then, you know, after 10 or so, yeah, I'd say probably, you know, 10, 12 seconds into a battle, you're going to be at full stacks with 20% base damage, buff, and dodge chance. Then I have Element of Surprise. When you use a Flourish power while stealth or invisible, you gain 25% damage bonus and critical hit chance. This talent is a must. Very, very good. This is where you're going to be seeing the major damage coming from run through, as well as Saber Storm, as well as your other Flourish, Death Blow. Next up, we have Everywhere at Once, Righteous Frenzy, and BAMF bomb reduce the cooldown of Brimstone Blitz by 1 second. As I mentioned earlier, really nice power. I just like to have that extra attack in my rotation, the extra invulnerability to survive. If you wanted more damage, you could go with Obscuring Brimstone, especially if you're doing just like boss runs or running through, you know, operations nonstop. This, I think, will do a little bit more damage, especially in a group, just due to the fact that once you get to the boss, your key, the key there is to just burn the boss down as quick as possible. So this will definitely do more damage, just due to every single one being a crit and those crits having a better chance of brutal. And then lastly, I have Saber Blitz, sword power damage, plus 10%. We use a Flourish within 4 seconds of a teleport power. Damage bonus, plus 75%. Again, this is always usually active just due to the fact that BAMF is considered a teleport power. It says they're right in the tag. So teleporting after every single attack shouldn't be a problem. It gives you that movement ability. You're going to be dodging around, pretty much dodging most attacks. And you get a plus 100 or minus 100% spirit cost reduction, which will make sure you do not run out of spirit, which is a problem while you're leveling up. My ultimate's up next, Reign of BAMF. Go get some stuff to throw down on your enemies and bring some righteous justice to the haters. BAMF, BAMF, BAMF. He is in a centralized location just throwing down like a rain of freaking items and objects. Does an absolute shit ton of damage. Whenever I use this, I try to pop it on like a boss, or if there's a lot of enemies clustered together, if I can kind of like rope everybody in, and it'll do quite a few million worth of damage. Usually brutals for 300-350k, you know, 26 hits. I'm seeing criticals, brutals, and normal attacks, so very nice ability. And then I'll kind of cut through my synergies below that, below the description here, as well as my infinity points, critical damage. With the innate 100% crit that he has from his stealth powers, I just wanted a ton of critical damage to go and boost that up, as well as brutal damage. So that pretty much sums everything up there. I'll be rolling some footage. You know, if you guys have any questions, definitely reach out. And again, sorry for the hiatus, but I am back, and I'm in a really good place, just having a lot of fun. And yeah, I think I'll be doing a Q&A here over, you know, the course of the next week or so as I get settled down and really really fine-tune everything. So again, I'll see you guys later. Have a good day. Peace out.